We windowed the block, number 6.
That can instantly patch, bond, seal, and repair.
1,061.
Let's tear down this torquey Cummins engine with only 5 good cylinders and see what the heck it looks like.
Starter's still good.
All right, guys, we found the first carnage. Broken rocker arm right here. This was laying under the cover. I just now noticed it. So it's been out in the open for like 10 minutes and I just now noticed. And this push rod is not in its spot anymore either. Dude, push rod, still straight. Look at that, old school. Power driven, tool steel, 08 of 2015. So this is a Frankenstein push rod. Solid, but dude, it's still straight. Totally gonna send that again.
Oh, that's the problem. This is made in China. It's hard to get
good American stuff anymore. Well, I got a headache. I'm gonna fix it.
I can't stop drinking because it's fizzing up.
Dude, check out the sheer amounts of Loctite we got on these bolts. This is going everywhere.
Yeah, did you torque these or did you hit it with impact?
All right,
I'm pretty sure he impacted him actually. Yeah, that's the way.
Here. Well, why would it sound?
Was the last?
No, it's tight.
That wobbles.
All right, we're pulling the injectors out.
Awesome. Yeah. The only one that was spotless.
Not problem. Head is off. Talk to us, Will.
Well, my first glance, my fire ring has lots of crush on it, for better or for worse. It's not very rounded, it's kind of like a little T-shape. So I went a little more aggressive on the crush because I was in 14s and I wanted to see if they'd seal better. And I was trying to lock the head of the block to keep it from breaking. So far, I'm not seeing anything. A little scuffing here on the thrust base, a little hard on that one. Let's pull this off. Just super crushed. Is this block good other than a broken rocker arm and
a hole?
And a hole.
I would have grabbed it.
Look, it's still wet. It's still wet. Look at that.
Touch it.
Now we're set up.
Making some noises.
I feel like this is Todd's cue to laugh at you. Oh, what was that? Tap, sir, ladies and gentlemen, is a tap hit.
Don't say that, that's what I have.
Oh, main board.
Broke.
What? You 100% torque those. Because you were like taking them way further than I was comfortable.
There isn't.
Oh, this one's like popped up. Look at that. It's got a gap right there.
Yeah, this one's loose. This rod looks tight.
Dude, this bearing looks new. You're asking for just a different mode of failure, and you're like, there's no way these mains will fail before my block cracks.
You freaking dynoed without a main drill.
There's nothing down there.
That one's loose and that one's tight.
So, lesson learned, factory 14 mil hardware is not good
for 1,550 horsepower.
Don't have to wonder anymore. I tested it for you guys.
I mean, I would be like, Will, are you sure you torque these? But I was there with you.
These are the German ones, too.
Look how bent that bolt is.
It's a little biscuit, dude. So I should have taken it to 4,000 RPM and seen where it topped out, right?
No, that's not the takeaway from this.
100%. Something got caught between the rod and the skirt and just boop. Right there,
the main block.
No wonder the flex seal fixed it, though. It wasn't really broke, it was just loose.
This one here is loose too, its companion's missing.
Wonder.
Dude, that bolt was literally hand-tied.
It was loose. So apparently if you spend money on main bearings, you don't even have to tighten the caps. We're gonna have to put the crank on the lathe and see how straight it is. If it's still good, I'm gonna use it in another project.
So this is number 5, Samokad. We'll have to look at the block. A bunch of stuff came apart.
So check us out. Okay, this journal here, which didn't have the bearings, was feeding that rod. Look at those bearings. I would describe that as barely reusable.
I would reuse that if I didn't have access to new bearings. It's because those coated V bearings, you can't destroy them. They're designed for top field dragsters. They laugh at a loose crank when it comes.
Yep, you heard it here first. If you plan, don't want to have a tight crank, just put V's. It'll be fine.
So going through here, number 1 tappets look pretty good. Number 2 tappets look not too bad. Number 3 tappets look good. 4 looks good. Meh. 6 looks good. Yeah. Not happy.
We should be.
Quarter inch. Something that happened.
That one's also snug.
Nope.
40 foot pounds. Probably like 40 foot pounds. Also more like 30. It wasn't that tight. That one?
So now you've effectively loosened 4 at this point.
I know. Oh, yeah, that one was like maybe 10 foot pounds.
You had a 4 tight bolts.
Pulled it off.
Okay, look at the gap there. As I spin it.
Can you see that?
I can see it.
Yeah.
That's gotta be, if you can see that much, it's gotta be 20, 30.
Yeah.
All right, quick recap. How did we get here? This is a newer storm block, had 12 millimeter mains. The guys at the shop were playing with a mag drill before we had a program written in the CNC to do main studs. And these holes ended up a little bit cockeyed from the mag drill or when they tapped, whatever. Something went wrong. Regardless, they weren't straight enough to put 14 mil studs in. They hit on the caps. And this was a standard bore block. And it pained me to throw away a standard bore block, and obviously I couldn't sell this to a customer sent out the door. And since I was having trouble blowing up blocks anyway, they're only lasting a race and a half, so I earmarked this for myself. I figured, what a great way. We'll test the block strength because it's full cylinder wall thickness, standard bore, and main bolts were the only thing that would fit. The Cummins ones are kind of undersized. So I put them in there. In the past, I've had success up to 1,000 horsepower on the Junker Drag Truck with factory main bolts. However, I think because these were side loaded a little bit, maybe they yielded. I don't really know. All I know is I've never pulled an engine apart and one of the main caps was sitting in the bottom and only 4 of the main cap screws were tight. So, and I tightened them. I have video footage of that. Meyer was there. We know these got torqued to, I think 160. And then I went right back at 165, maybe even 170 foot pounds. So they got torqued with a calibrated torque wrench. It didn't really last, but 10 or 15 dyno pulls, a couple trips down the drag strip, and that's why the block got windowed. It came loose, crank was moving around, rod must have tagged the side or tagged the cam, something, you know, with all that stuff moving around. We ended up with 2 broken tappets, had some metal and a main cap and some main screws floating around. Maybe the main screw did that. There's damage to the number 6 piston, so debris was hitting the underside of that. And the rest is history. So it truly was running on 5 cylinders though, because there was no rocker arm intact
The intake rocker arm was broken on number 5. But long story short, sometimes you gotta learn tough lessons in life, and this was a tough one to swallow. I screwed up, made a bad judgment call, and here we are.